wonderful day here in Argyll. What a trip we've got planned, honestly. Going camping for 3 days in Argyll, in that kind of basin next to Crinan. You know, we're going to see some beavers, we're going to see the Scottish Rainforest, we're going to see some villages that were cleared through the Highland Clearances. We're going to see some rock art that's 5,000 years old. The last time that I went to Argyll to try and find beavers in the Scottish Rainforest last year, it was too late in the year. See, when I was there, the place just reeked of history. There's a beautiful Scots pine tree there, driving past it. So before we reach the lock, we do have a few stops to make. The first stop will be, we're going to see some stone carvings, which are 5,000 years old. This is the thing, right? No one actually knows what the stone carvings represent. They're just kind of spirals and circles with rings. No one actually knows what it means. But I bet you £5, I go up there. Within 5 minutes, I've got the full thing figured out. How cool were they rock carvings? Genuinely. To give you context, right, of how old those rings are, right, 5,000 years old. The next place we're going to, Dunadd, that was the capital of an ancient Gaelic kingdom, right? To Dunadd, to the people that lived there in this ancient Gaelic kingdom, these rings will have been about 3,000 to 4,000 years old. That's nuts. I just think it's insane that something that old is preserved in the rock here. And fair play to all the people that have done well to preserve it. Right then, off to the next stop, are we? From here, at Dunadd, the capital of Dalriada, the former Gaelic kingdom that stretched from the north of Ireland all the way up to Skye. This place is special, in the middle of a glen, Kilmartin Glen I believe it's called. It sticks up, no wonder they made this place a fort. As you can see, we've got company. Don't know if you can hear me because of how windy it is, right? But I'm at the top of Dunadd, capital of the ancient kingdom, Dalriada. By the way, what a view up here. Check that out. Christ. Unreal scenes, eh? Scenes on toast. So that there was Dunadd, the capital of the ancient Gaelic kingdom of Dalriada. What a place, by the way. So atmospheric, see, when you're there, like, you can almost imagine the lives that were there before you. Like, see, putting your foot in and all that, you can imagine all the people standing round watching that. Like, see, when I was doing it, I was like, I felt like everyone was going to cheer me on. Kind of lift me up, like, hey, is the King of Scotland, there we go, my man. There's only one place left to go today. That's to see some beavers. So here's a plan, right? What we're going to do is we're going to jump into that forest behind me. We're going to find two trees that are 12 feet apart. We're going to get the old tree straps out and we're going to swing in our hammock. We're going to have a nice wee dinner, and by that time it'll be about 8, it's about 5 now. By that time it'll be about 8 o'clock, and then sorted, we can go see some beavers. Spend the twilight hours of the evening chasing beaveroids. From about 7:30 to 10, that's what we'll do. We'll check out the beavers and then we will crash, because what a day we've had, let me tell you. Let me tell you something, Daryl. What a day we've had here. So I had dinner. Now we're going to try and find beavers. Already had two close misses during dinner, as you'll see in the video.
Beaver!
This is where we'll be looking for beavers tonight. Shit. No! Him, isn't it? That's our man. That's our wee bear. No way, we saw our first wild beaver. Let's go. Finally did it, man. What a day. What a day. We finally saw beavers in the Scottish Rainforest. Sorry, beaver. We saw one, right? We saw one. Tell you what, by the way, I get wildlife photography and videography now. Like, whoa, what a rush that was. Genuinely. What a way to end the day, huh? Seeing actual wild beavers. The first ones in Scotland in over 400 years. And we fucking got them on video, man. We did it. Come on, man. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow we're going to some hard-hitting places. So be ready and enjoy. Come on.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are we doing? I'm so great, we sleep.
Just made my way to Kilmory Oib. This place is insane, by the way. So yeah, this was one of the places that was cleared by Neil Malcolm the 13th, believe it or not. So good they had 13 of them.
What do you think that is? Why is that?
It's a mailbox.
This is insane. Look at that.
I don't know if these are bits that have just fallen away or if they're supposed to be used. Do you know what I mean?
Look at all this moss on this wall. This is how you know that you're in a Scottish rainforest. Some of that, oh man, wow.
You're doing good, Mr. Moss, you're doing good. This is from the year 500. So this will be from the time that the Dalriada was about.
can see that there's a cross etched into it, but you can't really make it out, but it is there.
You would stand on here and get your water out there.
That's wild, man. This is a well from ancient Scotland. People have put coins in.
This village was like a communal area. Everyone lived together in close proximity. They looked after each other and they really did care for each other. And this was proved by the eviction notice in 1848, when all the land that Neil Malcolm owned, Neil Malcolm the 13th, basically told all of his tenant farmers to flit and remove themselves. Now, flit is an old Scottish word for just moving house. But essentially, they weren't going to take that lying down, so they joined together with the people of Arichonan and other kind of small villages around this area, and they actually resisted the eviction. But sadly, they were eventually cleared from the land. It was only 20 years later that these buildings were shown as abandoned and with no roofs, which is horrible. Horrible to think that in such a short period of time we can lose something like an entire village of people and an entire community of people. Just the loss of this, the clearances, is just incalculable, really. Incalculable. I mean, the stories, the songs, the poems, the art, the ballads, the knowledge of plants, lochs, animals.
So, now we're off to Arichonan, the second village that we're going to see because of the clearances. Now, these villages are so important to the Scottish story. Not because they just talk about, not just because they're part of the Scottish clearances, right? But see as well, they just sum up so much about Scotland at that time, these two villages. Right, we're 100% in here. This is where we're parking. Oh my god. So, just walking up to Arichonan now. Some walk. Tell you that much. Isn't that amazing all the way down there? Jesus. Just like thousands of other villages throughout Scotland, Arichonan was forcibly cleared during the Highland Clearances. Where there was once a thriving community, now stand stones that used to be homes. The laughter of children is gone, and all that can be heard in this beautiful place is the song of the local birds. Arichonan now stands as a monument to not only the Scottish clearances, but to the communities that were lost. Arichonan stands as a reminder of the consequences of our system of social alienation. Arichonan reminds us that sometimes to look forward, we have to look back so that the same mistakes are never made again.